Hey, what up? Rob of Cool Things with Rob, a YouTube channel where we look at cool things. In this episode, we're going to look at a 1934 Brewster limousine. I'm sure you're thinking, what the hell is a Brewster? To find one, I only needed to visit my friend Bill Marsh's place, or should I say museum. Bill is a vintage car collector, which, as you will see in a minute, is an understatement. All right, we are here with my friend Bill Marsh.
Hello, Rob.
Who I met, I believe, 10 years ago when I first bought a vintage Cadillac, and you were thinking about buying your first car. I still have one, and you've done better than I have, let's just say.
A few, yes.
The car we're going to look at today is a 1934 Brewster.
Yes.
I'd venture to guess most people today would not even have heard of a Brewster. What can you tell us about the Brewster Motor Company?
Brewster started in 1820 building carriages for the wealthy. They got into the car market building bodies in 1899.
All right.
And they built bodies for Rolls-Royce and a lot of high-end cars. And
you can tell in the look of this thing.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
And then in 1934, they began their own cars. They built it on a 1934 Ford chassis.
So it's really a kind of a combination of Ford and Brewster. Ford chassis,
yes.
Brewster carriage.
Yes, it is. It was built for a major opera singer named Lily Pons. She was the main soprano for the Metropolitan Opera for over 20 years.
Wow.
That was her car.
You mentioned something earlier that they built it for her weight and tailored it to her in some way.
Yeah, cars were built for the owners. They would tell you how what is the size of the chauffeur,
yeah.
What is the size of the person that's going to be sitting in it. And so it was built for her on one side and her husband, Andre Castellanos, the orchestra leader,
on the
other side.
Oh, I didn't know she was married to him.
Yes.
I think she's credited with actually saving the opera from bankruptcy, I read somewhere.
I heard that too, yes.
She would tool around, I guess, New York City, Manhattan, in this thing.
Yes.
Is that basically the purpose of the car, kind of a short haul luxury vehicle?
It was mostly luxury vehicle around town, yes.
First thing that jumps out at me is this grill. What's going on with this?
This grill was designed by a guy named Inskip, who did fountain pens. And that was the car that haunted me for years until I finally got it. I mean, it took me 6 years to get it. And I gave it to Anne last year for a Valentine present.
Oh, very nice. And this is the one that was owned by Lily Pons.
This one, yes.
And whose husband, Andre
Castellanos, right. Orchestra leader.
So it's got the open, even though you said there is a cover that can be put on here, but the chauffeur drives out in the open air.
Yes.
Very classy. I've only seen that in cartoons. This particular car in 1934 would have gone for about how much?
It sold for $3,500.
Who back in the day could afford that? It was in the middle of the Great Depression. Mm-hmm. People were struggling. Was it just the rich and famous, I assume?
It pretty much was the rich and famous. As we mentioned, it was Al Jolson owned one himself.
Jolson?
Al Jolson, yeah. Porter.
Oh.
In fact, Cole Porter made a musical called Anything Goes. There was a song in it because you're the rich. You're the rich, you're the hot toddy, you're a Brewster body.
I'll have to go find that one.
Yeah.
I'm sure I have the 45 at home. Where did it start? Where did it end up? And how did it end up with you, just very broadly?
Well, it went through major collections once that she had passed it on with something else. And we just recently got it from Truett Cathy Collection, who was founder of Chick-fil-A.
You've actually, beyond the Brewster, you've built a museum here for yourself.
We have a few cars. We did. Thank you.
So how did you get interested? I think I've seen some pictures of you as either a teenager, early 20s, and mm-hmm. Vintage motorcycle. How did mm-hmm. you get interested in vintage vehicles?
Well, I had a 1954 Vincent Black Shadow motorcycle.
That's the one I saw, where you had a cast.
Yes, and it was a wonderful, wonderful bike. But I passed it on too.
Very cool. All right, well, we are going to take a little ride. How does that sound?
Sure. Sounds
good. All
right,
let's do it.
See if we can start it up.
Okay.
Times have changed, and we've often rewound the clock. inhabitants got the shock when they landed on Plymouth Rock. If today any shock they should try to stem, instead of landing on Plymouth Rock would land on them. In olden days, a glimpse of stocking was a look on to something shocking, but now God knows anything goes. Good offers who once used better words, now only used four letter words, writing prose, anything goes. If driving fast cars you like, if low bars you like, if old hymns you like, if bare limbs you like, if Mae West you like, or me undressed you like, why nobody will oppose. When every night the set that's smart is intruding at nudist parties in studio, anything goes. When Mrs. Ned McLean, God bless her, can get Russian Reds to yes sir, then I suppose anything goes. When Rockefeller still can hoard enough money to let Max Gordon produce his show, anything goes. The world has gone mad today, and good's bad today, and black's white today, and day's night today, and that gent today you gave a cent today once had several chateaux. When folks who still can ride in jitneys find out Vanderbilt's and Whitney's.
We're all alone, no chaperone can get our number.
The world's in slumber, let's misbehave. There's something wild about you, child, that's so contagious. Let's be outrageous, let's misbehave. When Adam won his hand, he wouldn't stand for teasing. He didn't care about those apples out of season.
Well, I think you'll agree that was pretty damn cool. Assuming you agree, which I will take the liberty of doing, please like and subscribe. Thanks so much to my friend Bill Marsh and his amazingly cool collection of cars. I may be totally uncool myself, but I know a cool thing when I see one. Now get the hell out there and find something cool.